Hello, this is a tutorial series on how I made this animation. I will talk about some things that I think are important and some tips on Clip Studio Paint features that I utilize in this particular project. So the first step in any project is planning. In this case, I'm making a vertical pan, which means I will need a long background that will cover for the whole pan. Since I want to make a 4K animation, I will need a bigger document size than 4K. I use the overflow frame features to have both a long canvas and 2D camera in the size I want. You can make your canvas longer by inputting the size manually, but the camera will just use the original aspect ratio and you can't change that. But if you use the overflow frame, the camera aspect ratio won't be altered. So you can have both long canvas and the correct aspect ratio with this. You have two options when setting the size for the overflow frame. One is specified by scale and the other by size. Specifying by size is just inputting the pixel size manually. You can use that if you like, but in this case, I'm going to use the scale. You can change this value later if you need a larger canvas. I start with a simple sketch which I make very quickly. I will use this sketch to tweak the camera speed until I find the sweet spot. Once I finally settled with the speed and the movement, I will make this look better by adding depth, or rather the illusion of it. For that, we just need to have several planes moving at a different speed. This creates an effect we call parallax. What this means is landscapes and structures further away from the camera move slower. For this to feel effective, you will need at least 3 layers on a different planes. The closer the plane is to the camera, the longer they need to be, as they will move faster. In this example, I have 3 planes, which then later I separate them even more to enhance the effects. I will cover on how you can estimate the length of the plane based on your camera speed in the next video. If your playback is slow or not moving because of the long canvas, you can head over animation, playback settings, and prefer by speed instead of quality. You should have a smoother playback now. Moving on to actually making the backgrounds, I start by creating a color thumbnails, basically serving like a guide for the final painting. I will zoom out so I don't focus on the details and just the mood of the painting. Then I will put it on site as a reminder for the rest of the painting. As for the final painting, you could definitely detail every single corner. But what I do is I have less details on planes that viewers won't focus on, and even less if the plane is moving fast. You can even add motion blur later to improve the effects. On this project, the pawn area is my focus, as this is where my characters is and the camera will stop here for quite a while. And for the rest of the painting, I just leave them pretty much rough. I use a lot of lasso tools here for the tiny leaves. You can just make a bunch of selection then paint it with the brush. I will paint a darker color on the lower part to hint at shadows to make it look more three-dimensional. And another tool I use is the layer effects. In this case, I use the border effects to help me make the dangling roots. And once you got bunch of them, you can rasterize your layer to apply the layer effects. Then you can further blend it with the painting. Another thing I love to do while painting is to check my values or the grayscales. In Clip Studio, you can do this by using layer effects. You can go to layer properties and set the expression to gray. You can even set an action if you like by going to action, add an action. Start recording, then do the same steps. Stop the recording once you're done. Now you can check the value of your painting with a click. You'll need to make another action to reverse it back to color. That's about it for this episode. I will cover camera movement in the next video. Bye.